In sports tonight, there is probably really only one story that's on the minds of all sports fans, and that is the Super Bowl. Bruce Roberts, who do you like tomorrow?
I don't like the Jets. Who you like? I stick to my guns. I think the Vikings will win it by 7. Incidentally, on the subject of pro football, O.J. signed a new contract with Buffalo today. The new pact, 5 years, calls for a cool $1 million. In college bowl action, the North rallied to win the Senior Bowl, and through the courtesy of NBC Sports, let's look at some of the action, shall we? Early in the first quarter, South's ball at their own 31. Danny White had his pass tipped. It was intercepted by Matt Blair at the 42, and the North took over at the South 30. They couldn't move it much further, so Rich Sanger proceeded to kick this 30-yard field goal to make it North 3, South nothing. That was the score late in the first quarter. South's ball at their own 45. Wilbur Jackson's fumble was recovered by the North at the 46. On the first play after the recovery, Mike Barilla threw one complete to Heisman Trophy winner John Cappelletti, who went out at the 28. Then Cappelletti on a little solo job. The sweep right, number 22, got 12 more to the South 16-yard line. From there, Barilla to Cappelletti for 15. And the South had moved to the North 1 yard line. Where was Bull Mathers, who took it in? The extra point was blocked. It was 9-0 North. The South took the ensuing kickoff and drove to the North 34, where White pitched one to Woody Green, who took it down to the 16. The North held, so Greg Gant kicked his 27-yarder. It was 9-3 North at halftime. Early in the third quarter, the South in punt formation at the North 36. A little fake here. The short man Jackson ended up with it. He also got a first down at the North 30. But Ralph Brock quickly went to the pass. Fine catch by Harvey McGee to the North 8. But all that resulted in was this 35-yard field goal by Gant. It was North 9, South 6. A bit later in the fourth quarter, the South driving again. Wilbur Jackson provided all the heroics. This a 53-yard ramble. The South had a golden opportunity at the North 2. Then they took the lead on this option pitch to Woody Green. It was 13-9. With a little over a minute left in the game, the North started the drive that won it. David Jayne, Kansas, the quarterback. From the South 46, he threw to Gary Heyman out at the 33. Then it was the toss to Cappelletti, who finally went down to the South 18-yard line. Followed by the winning touchdown, Jayne spotted Lynn Swann, and the North had pulled it out of the fire. The final, North 16, the South 13. A big NHL contest this afternoon. First place Boston lost to second place Montreal. And again, we thank NBC Sports for the following highlights. From the faceoff at 5:35 of the first period, Yvon Lambert was there to rebound the point slapper. Canadians led 1-0. It became 2-0 Montreal when Cornwallier from back of the net centered to Jacques Lemaire. Watch number 27, Frank Mihalovich, at 13:04 of the period. Frank made it Montreal 3, Boston zip. But the Bruins came right back to score their first goal. Number 10, the left of your screen, Carol Vadney, slap shot off the power play, ended the first period, the Canadiens 3 and Boston 1. The Bruins narrowed it early in the second period. Ken Hodge tipping in this Phil Esposito shot, 3-2. But the Canadiens retaliated on a power play slap shot by Lemaire, number 25, his second goal of the game. And the second period ended, the Montreal Canadiens 4, over the shoulder, the Boston Bruins 2. Frank Mihalovich got his second goal early in the third period. Look at the wide open net. It was 5-2 Canadiens. It became 6-2 on a typical bit of Montreal sharp passing. Chuck Lefley ended up scoring the goal. Just beautiful. At 12:44 of the third period, Peter Mihalovich rebounded his brother's shot. The score mounted to 7-2. And the final goal of the game, Wayne Cashman scoring for the losers, but it wasn't enough as Boston drops its first at home in 22 games. Montreal 7, the Bruins 3. Turning to college basketball, fourth-ranked North Carolina State, easy over Clemson in Big Ten play, Purdue big over Illinois. The Spartans beat Ohio State. Michigan just got by Minnesota. Second-ranked Notre Dame had no problem, and fifth-ranked North Carolina had enough to get by Virginia. We have a couple of late finals. The big one, Indiana edged Wisconsin, 52-51, Northwestern 87, Iowa 67. In high school basketball, the Illinois High School Association suspension of Rock Island High School was rescinded, and its place, an additional 1 year's probation. In tennis, the U.S. won today's doubles match with Colombia. They still trail in their Davis Cup competition 2-1. And in golf, Johnny Miller and Miller Barber tied for the late third-round lead in the Phoenix Open. Have more to say on that Super Bowl tonight, Robert.
I kind of like the Dolphins. Maybe we'll get a little side bet going here.
You got it.
The Chicago Tribune reports in its Sunday edition that President Nixon wanted to fire the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff in 1971. The paper says the president was contemplating that action because he was angered by reports that the military was spying on Henry Kissinger, who was then Mr. Nixon's national security advisor. And that about wraps up our news for this Saturday night. We'll be back tonight at 10, and Bruce will have the highlights of the game between the Chicago Bulls and the Milwaukee Bucks. We'll see you then. I'm Bob Wallace. Good evening.
This kitchen drain can explain a lot about sinus miseries. When closed, it blocks. But when open, it drains. When your sinuses are open, there's no congestion pain. But when sinuses close, you've got blockage, congestion, pressure, pain. You want Dristan tablets, strong medicines to open sinuses, help drain off congestion, reduce pressure, relieve pain in minutes. Dristan tablets helps drain off sinus pain fast.
Carry the big fresh flavor wherever you go, whatever you do. It's the finest pack of flavor wherever you go, whatever you do.
Flavor this big shouldn't be left behind. So wherever you go, carry a pack of Wrigley's Spearmint Gum.
It's the finest spearmint flavor, the great Wrigley taste, delicious to chew.
Wrigley's Spearmint Gum.
This is Mrs. Moore. Earlier tonight, her son had a bad cough from a cold, but now she's sleeping soundly because she knew when to give him St. Joseph cough syrup for children to help put his cough to sleep. It has the best non-narcotic cough suppressant in a formula effective for children. It relieves his cough for hours so he can rest, and now so can Mrs. Moore. Cherry-tasting St. Joseph cough syrup for children helps put the cough to sleep.
How can we help solve the energy crisis?
Burn our furniture?
Come to Wick's January bonus sale for the furniture you've been dreaming about. Bonus savings in every department. It's Wick's first big sale of the year. Save on best-selling items and one-of-a-kind pieces. There's no waiting for delivery. And Wick's has a credit plan to fit most every need.
Hey, what a beautiful solution.
Dreams don't have to wait at Wick's.
The world's largest furrier, Evans, presents Chicagoland's greatest January fur sale. Have fun in his or her rabbit coats, only $175. You can take home this master creation of natural blue fox. Or beautiful contemporary mink coats, just $588. Look to the ultimate, our collection of designer-inspired mink coats, only $1,188. Enjoy incredible savings at Evans on magnificent furs in the world's greatest January fur sale.
TV2, Chicago.